Hi everyone, Ian here, and I'm currently in San Diego on Shelter Island, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2010 Catalina 445. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular sailboat has to offer.
Here we are looking at the 2010 Catalina 445. This is actually the dinghy that goes with the vessel. Starting at the bow, we can see a double bow roller with a large rock nut anchor, furlex furler. Beautiful Catalina, you know, style design here on the 445. We do have a large overlapping head sail there. This is a double Selden spreader rig. And up at the top, we have 1-point wind speed, wind direction, TV antenna, radar, steaming light, LED downward deck light. These are the straight spreaders, so you see a lot of the rigging that is associated with them. And then we also have the in-mast furling with a newer North Sails main. So really nice option there. Selden rod kicker, and then our large traveler connected to the boom itself. This particular Catalina 445 has some really nice additions. And as we walk up into the vessel, you're gonna see this large cockpit here. This is the upgraded hard top Dodger with Macrolon glass here, built-in grab handles, fiberglass top here. We have the Flexi-Teak on the side decks cabin top. All the hatch covers are all properly covered, so keeping them in really good condition. The vessel itself is lightly used. So the ground tackle on this has also been upgraded with a large stainless steel swivel. This opens up here in the anchor locker itself. We have the large windlass up and down. It also has the divider, so you can carry two anchor systems and or separate the chain and road like the current owner currently does. Looking back aft, you can see really, again, beautiful lines, aluminum solid tow rail that goes from bow all the way to the stern. There are three cleats on each sides with proper rollers leading to the cleats themselves. All the sheets, halyards lead into the cockpit, and this is actually, the canvas is in beautiful condition. Coming into the cockpit, you're going to see these large bench seats off to both starboard and port side. Centrally located is the cockpit table. This is a high gloss varnish cockpit table. Has compass built into it, a little storage area, grab handles, the leaves that fold up on both sides. And then as we walk to the transom, you can see there is a little bridge closure here. But look at this. Two little moderate steps, and we got this large transom with additional storage. There's also foldable cleats here, so if you're bringing your dinghy up, you can cleat it off on both sides and board quite easily. Swim step ladder underneath this center opening. We have a built-in stainless steel bracket for the outboard. Stern rail seats, which are really nice. And then off to the port helm, we have nice stainless steel wheel that's wrapped in leather, multi-repeater, wind point, wind speed, and large Lumar winches. Really nice grab handle pedestals here, built-in cup holders, stereo remote off to the inboard side of it. And then as you sit down, you have your engine displays, RPM, gauge, fuel, voltage, and there are 300.5 engine hours, so very, very low engine hours. Here we have a VHF RAM mic, and then the owner's done a nice custom addition, building up the pod much higher with a newer Raymarine glass mat Axiom display here. This is all touchscreen and it has the new radar antenna. But this is great because you're standing here at the helm, you have it right in front of you, but at eye level, you have phenomenal visibility. Also, we have a multi-repeater. This is our graphic display, and then our ST6002 autopilot. We also have a bow thruster control, so that makes it really nice to single hand and or shorthand sail. Throttle controls are down here, but really nice open cockpit, very, very wide. We have a hatch underneath here that goes into the aft cabin that lifts up for headroom. Cockpit cushions, as you can see, and this large opening hatch leads us down into the additional double bunk and or storage unit, depending on how you set it up. But again, notice the attention to detail where they did the Flexi-Teak, even up on the cabin top, here up underneath the Dodger. We have a single speed Lumar electric winch off to the starboard side. and then all of our clutches and everything leading into the cockpit. Line holders and a companionway door that just closes off, so that's quite nice. All right, so as we come down below, again, look at this, built-in stainless steel grab handle here. This hard dodger is quite nice. All right, so now let's go down below. As we come down below, the galley's off to the port side. This is your L-shaped galley with extended cabinet here behind the door. So it really gives you a little bit more additional space. Lighting switch here, isotherm refrigerator, double stainless steel sinks, Corian countertops. And then we have this opening area here for additional fridge here, or storage ice box, three burner stove and oven. As I mentioned, this little island area gives you a little bit additional space, additional storage. And then right behind this is our bunk bed storage unit. So you could set it up with two people down here, another person up on this side, and or have this up over. So it is a large, you know, storage area with shelving. So this is quite nice. You know, the Catalina 445 does some really cool things. One thing I really like is this little compartment here. So you have access to your sea strainer, Raycore filter, and you can see some additional spares. So this is kind of in that utility room bonus third cabin. Microwave, overhead stove hood, again for this three burner stovetop, that's quite nice. Phenomenal headroom, lots of opening, you know, space here on the Catalina 445. Beautiful teak interior with teak and holly floors. The companionway steps are situated quite nice. I like how they have that floating look appeal to them. Directly across from us is the day head. And here you also have access into the VIP cabin as well too. Electric toilet, there is a shower curtain that'll close off the toilet in this area. So this can also be used as a shower. Nice big thick doors going into the aft cabin. You can see here that the bed is off a little bit on this angle, so it does allow you a little additional room. There's an overhead opening hatch, shelving, large hanging locker, shelving areas, and as I mentioned, this access point to the head shower compartment as well from here. Back side of the engine, front side of the engine, and then also the steps themselves will come up, so you can really gain access to the Yanmar engine right here. All really nice flat flooring here in the salon. The nav station is set up quite nicely. I really like the touches of like the smoked glass top, you know, just really kind of sets it off. We have our inverter main breaker here, our windlass control breaker, battery switches here, ICOM M422 VHF, Jensen stereo, Blu-ray player, and then behind the smoked glass panel, we have our breaker system. So our 120 volt and our 12 volt systems are nicely situated there. Just a really nice touch. This is all custom interior that this current owner has done here. So it's a really nice shade of blue, a nice fabric material. Again, nice headroom, overhead space, flat screen, Samsung television, Bose speakers. And then off to the starboard side, this little area here can be split up as you see it with the table, or this table drops down. Filler cushions go in, turns it into a bench. Behind this cabinet is our access to our battery monitor. Our tank indication gauge is here, and then this will also show us our water tanks. All right, coming up to the forward cabin. Also, before I go up there, but you can see this salon table. This is quite beautiful, and its design, how it opens up, as you can see. So it turns into a quite larger flat table and or smaller table that's just a little easier to get around, but it also has the support fiddles there. Okay, coming into the master cabin, we have hanging locker storage, large countertop space here. There are lots of opening hatches. Catalina is really well known for doing that. Teak battens that lay into this kind of shelf right here, little bench seats off to both sides. And then we also have a little vanity area located right here with a little bench seat. So that's quite nice. Nice, comfortable mattress. And then now we have the master shower compartment. Compression post is right here. We have a large mirror sink, separate shower where that shower curtain discloses that off, and the electric head. These are also custom teak grates that the owner had made. All right, coming back through the salon, so we'll give you a little different perspective, but it is a nice, warm, cozy, quality offshore cruiser. All right, well, thank you again for watching. I hope you found it to be helpful and informative. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Bye for now.